Please stand and pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening. Today is March 3rd, 2014. Time is 7 p.m. The regular meeting of the Greensburg Common Council is called to order. It's time for these problems in the economic process. Roll call, please, Bridget.
Blake.
Here.
Glenn.
Here.
Terry.
Here.
Darrell.
Here.
Jamie.
Here.
Now, next item is approved minutes from past meetings. Is there any councilman that weren't here for any particular meeting?
I wasn't here for the special January 27th.
Okay, December 2nd, 2013 meeting, the minutes. Do you see any amendments or changes that need to be done for that date?
I've got a couple of under the ordinance 2013-17 and 2012, amending the ordinance, I really think there ought to be included in this a short explanation of why that is being amended. The next one down where it says, Mayor Herbert requested board members, I really think that should read council members. And then his request to speak to public meeting form probably ought to be some way designated as a specific form or a specific title or a specific item as opposed to my recommendation. And further that same paragraph, board members, the council members, and those who would not adopt the use of the form at city council meeting. And I, under the next, the clerk treasurer, Bridget Weber, clerk treasurer requested final approval. Line, just it's a reversal, the letters there, instead of line times, it should be line items. And then that, the second line there, at the end it says, could, should probably left out B combined, to coincide with the state board account. And that minutes from other boards slash commissions, because two more three commissions should be added there. The next one where it says that the SIHO, is that the name of the company or is that the acronym for the company?
That's the name that they use. They have, I think they use that as their logo and their name. I mean, I think it has a meaning, but I have to go back and look and see what it is.
That's where I know it.
SIHO is their company name, but they, I mean,
All right, well, if that's their company name, then, oh, that's fine.
I mean, whenever the board wants to have a pretty much TPA contracts, they can use SIHO as
well.
Okay.
All right.
Does that need to be changed?
Well, if that's their official name, then,
SIHO Insurance Services on the cards.
It stands for Southern Indiana Health Organization.
I knew it had a meaning, but they don't use it. I mean, that they count.
Okay.
But I can use whatever. That's what you guys need to decide.
And then again, near the end of this paragraph, it's again that same except with the request form to speak at public meeting. probably ought to be consistent in how we title it. So it's request to speak at public meetings form, or I don't know exactly what, how it was titled. Earlier you had it that way, and here we've got request form to speak at public meetings. Again, may need to be identified as a specific item or a specific form.
I think it's specifically titled request to speak form.
And that's what should, that's in the, it'll be changed.
Yeah, there's still ongoing discussions related to that form. For the purposes of the Councilman Tebbe is discussing, I believe it was called request to speak form.
Right.
Is the title, so that's how it should be.
That's how it should be.
It should be identified.
So those are my recommendations.
Is there one during that? Because you have everything.
I think so.
And I would entertain a motion to approve the minutes with the changes and amendments as suggested.
So.
Motion made by Blake, second by Terry. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion passed unanimously. Next is January 13th meeting. We've been our regular meeting that been postponed due to the weather. Any changes or corrections in those minutes for January 13th?
Again, I have some. Beginning there, we said minutes from December 13th were requested. I think it should read Bridget Weber, Clerk Treasurer, requested minutes on December 2013 be tabled for the February meeting period. Under Patty Jackson, fourth from a home improvement grant. Again, I think for clarity, it really ought to be stated where this grant was from and what the amount was, and that Greensburg contributed $6,000 as a match. Jaded, very low performance. Under the public library item, I don't believe that the resolution was refinance bond. I think it was for new bonds. I think it was a refinance bond. So I think they asked for request adopting resolution to authorize bonds to construct a new roof for library. To authorize, I think we were, they had to get our permission to provide for the bonds, to allow the bonds to be.
So just to add authorize and strike for refinance?
No, I'm asking a question to see if I'm correct or not.
I don't know if we were in the process of issuing new bonds and refinancing everything or adding additional bonds.
Well, they told us they were paying off. Yeah, this last year, the half a payment and so forth, we went through that whole thing. So I'm pretty sure it was that they're going to go after new bonds for this, they would have a new set. So.
Yeah, because they did say they had that last payment to make.
Right.
Authorized new bonds.
And instead of saying staff from our law, I think we ought to identify who it was that was here and answer our question, spoke.
Do you have their names, Lynn? Because I don't think it's clear on the audio.
Yeah, I don't have the name in front of me.
I'd have to contact them.
You can contact the library, I'm sure they can tell us. And Don Wickens. Under the next item, Bridget Weber, Clerk Treasurer, requested, it's probably an amendment, not an, strike the D. Of job description and titles in the clerk's office, and to consider amending ordinance, or requested us to amend ordinance 2013, not to consider, because it was what we did, and to amend ordinance 2013-7 salaries for employees. During the State Board of Accounts, the audit of 2012, it was requested, I think we ought to say auditors requested the clerk to segregate the type of the duties. And then where the next line where it says total salaries of Berkeley for 2014 would not change, but personnel administrator position, I think we need the word position there, will have fewer duties, make so much less. Again, the accounts payable, account receivable position, more duties balancing accounts. Toward the end, we talked about passing the ordinance 2014-1, second reading, and I had the impression that we also, you requested us to make the change in the positions, the title of positions. You said there were a couple other small adjustments within the job description itself. There's nothing reporting here for us saying that we did approve that. Am I wrong? Right? I don't know. It's what my memory tells me. But my notes, I thought, indicated.
Do you remember what the additional responsibilities were? What the change in responsibilities?
The only thing that was added to the accounts payable, accounts receivable position would have been adding HR responsibilities or payroll responsibilities, however it wants to be, we'll state that. That was the only thing that was added to the job description. Accounts payable, accounts receivable.
There's something else about it.
Did we take something away from the other position?
No, we only added. Because what was happening is there was only one person that was doing was in their job description to do a payroll application or do HR applications. Whereas we need to be able to do some cross-training and be able to everybody build them both, not everything, but be able to, whether it's, you know, 1 week this person's doing it, next week the next person's doing it. So the accounts payable and receivable person, that was added to there. So it's their paragraph in the job description on the personnel administrator that was added to the accounts payable. But it's just directed to payroll.
Did we not also make a change in the title positions?
I think you created a new position.
You renamed it.
You renamed it.
Co-deputy clerk treasurer. It's personnel administrator. But the salary was what we would be. 2014-1 should have just been, it was salary, but we labeled who the people are in the ordinance and what the new salary was going to be, or amended salary was going to be, because it didn't exceed the amount that was approved in the 2014 budget. One thing that changed was the name of the position and the amount of money that they were paid.
I think you took the type of deputy.
Deputy clerk treasurer, I changed that out. I mean, the job description didn't really change it, just the title on that.
Right.
And the accounts payable, accounts receivable person had payroll added to their job
their title didn't change.
But their title, well, it did with, you know, it said account specialist, and now it's accounts payable and receivable position.
Naming those as council function, is it not?
Did the ordinance not have that listed in there with their name? I thought it did.
I didn't bring the ordinance back with me tonight.
Well, my question, the ordinance specifies the actual title and so forth and the salary, but in terms of...
I don't think you made a specific motion separate from the ordinance approval.
You didn't. The only thing you did is approve the ordinance as it was presented.
But the ordinance had those positions listed in them. What they dollar...
She requested an amendment of job description and titles. That's what I'm going on, that's what we did do. We agreed to that.
But then that 2014 dash one. I didn't want to talk about the ordinance. But it had the two positions with the two salary amounts, just for the clerk's office.
I'll say, so we can resolve this by adding the new job description title, job title.
Well, which was within 2014 dash one, so are we explaining what 2014 dash one's contents are? Is that what the request is?
Job description is attached, titles, job description, you, the titles, you say, right?
Okay.
So we can add a job title, just to give you a...
I can do that.
Next page, I would think that the easement for Duke Energy ought to be identified as where it is. And,
well, I'd say that's probably in the Board of Works minutes, where that would be at. It was just a report about it.
Yeah, that was just a report of the Board of Works, or from Board of Works.
What the Board of Works covered.
And Board of Works mentions that it's on Nightingale and Bearshell. So are we needing to detail what the Board of Works review is?
Not necessarily. In the last paragraph there, I requested the annual reports from the departments, it's 2012 and 2013. And then I also, reports, the ordinances, I think we ought to name those because I have specific ordinances identified for reports in the February meeting. Is the trash and sign ordinance.
You want the numbers on there too?
No, I think just identifying which ones we're talking about is what this what I asked for.
Just those two.
Those are the two that I mentioned to you tonight. And I, if the mayor's secretary position be reviewed by the personnel committee, and I had a specific area that why they needed to do that. It was to, I think it's to become an exempt, I think it's exempt is the right word, the employee could add that clarity there to, for that.
The rest of us got to be right. There's one on that. So with those additions and corrections, changes, I make a motion to accept the minutes as amended. Motion made by Blake.
Second.
Second by Garrett. say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Thank you, Council. The February 3rd minutes.
That's January 27th.
January 27th, excuse me. Special meeting for the funding request in 2014. Are there any additions or corrections to this?
Move approval.
And make the motion to approve in a second.
Aye.
Very seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Jimmy, you abstain. Now, next and final, February 3rd, regular comment.
Again, I would ask that the beginning of the minutes, December and January, rather, the statements would be presented, clerk treasurer requested that the minutes in December 2013 and January 2014 meetings. Be presented at the last meeting. And I, it's probably more me than anybody else, but the way it's worded here at the end of this first page, where it talks about the Board of Works update, Brian Redding requested, he wasn't approved, Brian Redding requested the road closure for St. Mary's 5K in August. And Charlotte Bailey requested the use of the city streets for Delta 5K in April. Dave Schultz requested, and you can also say that the city approved each of those things. All the way through, it just gets, it just seems odd that.
You could also just strike was approved on each one of those sentences and just put received approval. Because they're all followed by the modifier four.
Yeah, because they're not requesting from that board, it's requested from the board that would.
I know, and that's what I'm saying, we have to report that.
Sure.
It was approved, and if you want to put in there who requested it, that's fine, but.
But it was approved at that.
At the Board of Works meeting, that's what you're doing. It's just the way it's worded.
But you can just do what Chris mentioned, you just strike out was approved and put received approval.
Anything else? Entertaining motion to accept the minutes as amended.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Blake, second by Darrell. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign.
Mayor, could I make a recommendation?
Sure.
On the minutes, I realize we did get behind here, short staffed and all. Is there any way that we could receive these maybe a couple of weeks after the council meeting?
I'm hoping you'll have them by tomorrow.
That way we can look over them and then we actually know what we're approving at the meeting.
That's my problem, I have a little brain to go through.
It's a good idea. Time for bidding, you know, might be something, may not happen every month, but I think that should be.
I know that's the way we do it with the redevelopment commission, it works pretty well.
Okay, no business, new business, first item, agenda that is your emergency engineer.
Thank you. You should have found in your packet a new ordinance to, I believe the first one on the agenda is the Schroeder parcels. Back in 2008, there was an annexation down around the 74-421 interchange. The two Schroeder parcels were left out of the legal description but included within the map. We consulted two different attorneys. One said it was obviously intended to be included. Everything around it was included. We'll just go ahead and annex it. We talked to the attorney that really did the annexation for the city, and he said he felt it was more proper to do ordinances to clean them up and actually include them by legal description, which is why the two parcels are there for the Schroeder property. The 2008 annexation was done partly by legal description and partly by just parcel numbers. The legal description chopped the two INDOT parcels, which are the second one, into pieces, so we were just bringing those in as whole parcels that were not included instead of rewriting legal descriptions. So that's the reason for both of them. The Schroeders right now have signed on behalf of the trust a voluntary annexation form. Again, on the attorney's advice that since this was all intended and this is just an oversight, he suggested we not go to the Plan Commission with this. Because again, you had the intent that everything was supposed to have been included. So we brought it here for the first reading, and if you'd like to suspend the rules for the second, that will be good. For some other things that Economic Development is working on with a couple of these parcels. So the first one, I believe, is the Schroeder, and of course, it's not for approval, or if anybody has any questions or discussion before move on. I thought they were pretty self-explanatory with the exhibits that went along, A and B. So pointing out which ones were not included.
I think the amount of parking on one parcel is about 5 foot wide. How long?
It's probably 300 foot long by 5 foot wide. It's the grass strip on the east side of the driveway that was in, ended up in another section. Just got missed because it was so long and narrow. On the other one, it's kind of almost a triangular shape. A piece from the Schroeders. If we could vote on them separately, that'd be great because we've got a little more additional information on the INDOT portion.
Okay, is there any more questions or comments over the 2014-2? If not, I'd like a motion to pass this ordinance 2014-2 on first reading.
Second.
Motion made by Vance, second by Link. All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Hearing none, I entertain a motion to suspend the rules and regulations to get this for a second reading.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Darrell, second by Jamie. Motion to suspend the rules and regulations for second reading. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion passes. Entertain a motion for second and final reading, 2014-2.
So moved.
Aye. Motion made by Blake, second by Glenn. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion passes. Something else we have done differently this month too, we just did today, but we will start doing this in the future. A lot of times the audience or the public doesn't know what ordinances we're working on. And so we are now posting them on the Greensburg website for review prior to meetings. Okay, Gary.
The second one is the INDOT parcel. The legal description that went across, jumped across the interstate, cut those two parcels in two. I've been down to INDOT, talked to their real estate department on Friday. Deputy director of the Seymour District gave the gentleman I talked to the authority to sign it, a voluntary annexation. He didn't feel comfortable without talking to another gentleman, but I don't anticipate any problems. They're non-taxable entity, whether they're in the city or outside, it's not going to make any difference to them. So if there was a motion on this one, I would ask it to be conditioned upon approval of their signing of that voluntary annexation petition.
Can we wait until the next month to file the second reading?
You could. I mean, the Schroeder signed, they're eager to get that in the city. Realize it was an oversight before. INDOT realizes the same. I was just preparing at the same time. I thought I would get it signed on Friday, and they're in the packet, so.
I hear a couple of passing on first reading, I just thought maybe we'd wait.
If we want to wait for the final until next month, that'd be great.
Can we have it?
We should have it signed by then.
Yeah, that was my.
Entertain a motion to have the first reading on the 2014-3 INDOT annexation.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Jamie. And second by Blake.
Darrell.
Darrell made a motion.
Jamie made a good point, though, that providing we get the.
We're only passing on first reading. We'll wait till next month to do second reading. If we don't do a second reading, it's a moot point.
Right.
But if we put that in there, then it reminds us when we see the minutes that we. Reminder to.
The minutes should say that we pass it on first reading only. So that should tell us.
I'm saying that if we put that condition in there, it reminds us to ask for that signature to ensure we got it. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I believe, if I may, I don't think you necessarily need to have a contingency upon your ordinance passage. You just need to ask that the record properly reflect that prior to second passage, the necessary to receive approval of that.
Put that in.
Who made your motion?
Darrell, one second.
Darrell made the motion, one second.
Probably second.
This is for first reading.
Sure.
Not voluntary annexation.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. Motion passed, first reading.
Thank you.
Okay. Next item is something that probably the majority of cities and counties have done in the state of Indiana, and several schools. There's been joint resolution between cities and counties and schools. And at this point, the county council can pass the resolution in opposition of the personal property tax repeal, which is Senate Bill 1 and House Bill 1001.
I guess this is according to the county commissioners that passed.
Oh, that's the county council, the county commissioners. So it was the county commissioners, excuse me. And most of us who it affects have been keeping up with what has been going through the state legislature and how it could affect cities, counties, schools, solid waste, library, fair board. Legislative meetings held at RUMC Saturday morning, there was more drastic figures, and much less for the city of Greensburg, $4,500. So I don't know really what to do at this time. I don't trust them until after March 14th, when it's over. This is something we can afford based on the way it was originally proposed. It would affect the city of Greensburg $424,000, the school corporation $303,000, $50,000 to the library, about $10,000 to the solid waste board. It goes on and on. $187,000, I think, it was to the county. And so, if there is, in fact, have that little of impact on us, then it's going to be very little done on personal property tax reduction. So we really don't know where it's at right now. But if you, I'm sure you read the resolution, and basically the last paragraph says it all. I'd like to read that so you understand it. That the common council of the city of Greensburg, Indiana states to our legislators that any legislation to repeal or reduce the village's personal property tax should be provided a method whereby the resulting lost municipal revenue should be replaced with adequate alternative revenue so that local government services would not be adversely affected. Additionally, without new or additional taxes imposed by the state of Indiana on our citizens and businesses that would eliminate the business personal property tax. I was taking away from one and adding someplace else. I support the elimination of the business personal property tax. It's good for business, it's good for the economy, it's good for jobs and growth. But you can't do something like this in a short session and make it right. So what we've recommended through here is for them to have a summer study committee on what they have proposed on the Senate bills and ask the House bill for the elimination of the personal property tax. Any questions or comments, Council?
Mayor?
Sir?
They haven't, according to the mayor, been asked that even up there. They haven't even come up with an alternative, have they? I mean,
they had given something out Saturday at our legislative meeting at RMC and suggesting things to replace it by 20, I think the House of Representatives, maybe it was 20 years recommended up on abatements of personal property in 25 years by the governor or vice versa, one of the others. 25 year abatements. That's a long time. And what we have now is working pretty well. And we're doing well within the United States of America, within the other 50 states. I think there's other areas that they need to be working at more. That's the education and the training, increasing the skills and abilities of our workers to give businesses what they need to run their business. So I think it might be one step to get here. This might be something that will work down the road in a short while in the near future. I don't think we're ready for this month.
We would get tax credits anyway for your business.
We do. And if you read through here, it tells all this and where we are at in the nation, state of Indiana. It's got all the information here. So the state's done a good job. They've given locals a leeway to grant abatements. I think it's been a reasonable amount of time. I think the Board of Assessors is a long time for abatements.
Any other
questions, gentlemen? What I'm asking for is a motion to pass this resolution that this council that represents the constituents of Greensburg does not support repealing business personal property tax at this time.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Motion made by Darrell and second by Blake. Any further discussion? Roll call on that, Bridget.
Blunt.
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
James.
Yes.
Blake.
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Council, for supporting the county commissioners and the tenants, Washington as well. Dealing with what we currently have given to deal with. Hopefully, we can do something differently in the future.
Purchased 7 used radios. these would have cost $21,000 had he bought them new. He was put in contact with someone who refurbishes, is that the right word, Scott? And was they, he's able to get those for $5,600, so quite a savings to the city. Donna Letter, the water department head, came to the board requesting a an adjustment, and she received that adjustment of $1,392.29. This was on a property the owner lived in Indianapolis, had a water leak because of the weather, and so we paid the water bill and we adjusted the sewer bill. Police Chief Stacy Chastain talked to us about replacing the police vehicle that was totaled in the accident a few weeks ago, and was given the latitude to pursue purchase from Andy Moore Chevrolet. Andy Moore Ford. Right?
Yes.
I can't read when I'm writing, I apologize. Tom Wertz came to the board. He is our insurance consultant, and gave us a few options. Specifically, the consult a doc program costing the city $4.95 per month per employee, and it is a program that we agreed to go forward with, and it's believed that this was be a savings to the city. It will pay for itself three or four times over. And he is also working on discounts from local caregivers here in the city. That's all I have here.
Questions, comments? This time we have open public discussion. Anyone like to speak? If you would, please come forward. Yes. Questions, concerns? Have you had an opportunity to go through the reports?
First off, thank you. Well done. What we have here, thus far, anyway. There's a lot of information here. I don't know if you've all had a chance to look through it or not, but what I would recommend is, since we've got this Friday afternoon, really, and may not have had real time to look through it and read it, to make, formulate any kind of questions or things that you'd like to follow up with, my recommendation would be that we would take two at a time each month to go through in a thorough way with the department head, to respond to our questions or just to discuss what's there and get any clarification we need. But as I look through here in the two instances or the three instances we have, I think we've got good information, useful information, somewhat enlightening, and where we go from here is, I think we ought to take time and follow through. Here's my recommendation. I don't know if any of you have had real time to do that yet.
By the way, I think it's good information that really citizens of Greensburg really need to know a lot of this.
These are things that we do, you're right, these are things we do on an everyday basis for the benefit of this community.
Right.
We cut costs, we've been frugal, and we just don't let people know what we do.
Right, and I think this would be a great opportunity to expose that and even maybe generate some feedback from the community and what we can do better, or? I think this is great.
I think so, then we should get to the next meeting. I know what we are doing.
Good people leaving the departments.
And you know, this has been a very busy time, you know, with all the bad weather we've had, things going on. We appreciate your patience with us. This is the first time I'm gonna recall passing this kind of report from our department heads. We haven't done it. Greg, can you remember it in all your terms?
Yeah, I had, we had some information earlier in the years, different times, but mostly police and fire kinds of things, not the others. In terms of, when we get to that point, there's some formatting things I'd like to recommend, but in terms of being able to utilize the information well and see the trends and comparisons and so forth. The street and sanitation department has got a few things that I need to follow up with when we schedule them for the time that everybody had a chance to read through it and get their own questions formulated about this.
I would recommend we have a special meeting for that, and so we can come here and just concentrate on that, because we've got questions and answers about that. And there's also maybe room for improvements, or the things they can explain to me why they're doing what they are and how to handle that.
Well, that's fine. I don't want a special meeting, but our meetings are not that long that we can't take a couple at a time, too. But I'm hoping the rest of the members, what they have to say.
It's kind of good to do by fresh remembering, because, you know, July's going to come pretty quick to the budget, and I'd like to have all this done before then, for sure.
Well, if we do two next month, and then two, well, I mean, there's some departments that are missing.
Yeah.
Which departments are missing?
Well, planning department's missing, water, sewer.
I think what we need then, Glenn, from you is a detailed request of what you expect and what you want. I know you said ordinances, why change ordinances, how's it affect this? We went way above beyond that, you know, as far as showing what we're doing. I don't want to prolong things. I just want to know exactly what the council expects, what they would like to see, so we don't have to come across this again where we didn't do a great job. But we're more than willing to do it.
I think some basic information is what we need. I think that the department heads probably could come up with what are the things that they think we ought to know about their job, about what they do, about the kinds of things that they're going to be coming to us for changes. Yeah. Whether it's changes in personnel or changes in requests for dollars or rates or whatever it might be. Rather than giving us a little slice of information at the time that they're making this request, I would like to have a set of information that gives us some history based on all the information that's there. So, this is not a fishing expedition. I'm not trying to find fault. I'm trying for us to be able to do our job well. As you just said, the information that's contained here is positive. So I'm not trying to be argumentative. I think that kind of positive information is what we need to know, as well as after we look at it, we may have some further questions, and there may need to be some follow-up clarification or additional information, but that's don't see that as trying to be.
Do you know right now exactly what you'd like to have in those departments that are missing? The plant commission, the water, and the wastewater?
I would think that those departments ought to be able to give me, us, not me, a clear picture of what they've done these past 2 years, what their functions are, what kind of, what's happened, what their responsibilities are, and how they've met them.
Mayor, if I may, we could have a request or a point of communication.
Well, I was gonna ask. Superintendent Denny, do you understand right now what you need to do?
It's something I do for my water board every January. It's called an operations report. So if you'd like a copy of that.
That may be it. I think that may be where you're, where the disconnect may have occurred here. Because I understand from what you've requested, but the three entities that you've identified all have their own separate boards. But I understand what you're asking for. I think that may be where the mayor's seeing a disconnect here, because they obviously would have to report to their boards to justify their existence. But I think your request is certainly reasonable.
Are we, can council respect this annually?
I would think this would be a good annual.
Okay, so council gets the, what Rick terms that, once we get that just every year in our packet, once a year?
To the council?
Yeah.
No, I just submit it to my board. It's not a big issue. I can give every January. I can put a copy of my operations report.
And Mr. Smith, you understand what you need?
Yeah.
Gary, do you understand what you need from the plant commission?
I listened to the tape. I wasn't at the last one where it was requested, but I heard about a new sign ordinance. We've done 16 new signs since the ordinance was in effect, and we've not had any applications to the BZA for variances based on the new ordinance. That's what I heard of the request for the meeting. If there's more than I need than that, please let me know.
Well, the sign ordinances had a whole area of what did you do to notify